A new library of assets has been brought to Houdini, so let's take a look at it and what all it has to offer. So this library that we're going to be taking a look at is from the Greyscalegorilla library of assets, so it's Greyscalegorilla Plus. If you guys are familiar with Cinema 4D, that's where I originally started with my 3D journey, and I used Greyscalegorilla back when I was using Cinema 4D, and then they didn't have anything for Houdini, but now they do. They brought all their stuff over there. Full disclosure, before we go any further, they did give me access to the Greyscalegorilla Plus library, so keep that in mind, but I'm not making any money off of this or anything like that. It's just purely they gave me access so that I could take a look at it and share it with you guys, see if it's something that you guys are interested in. So basically, this library has a bunch of different models in it, but the big thing for me at least is it has a bunch of materials, textures, all that stuff, HDRIs, all ready to go that you can use inside your Houdini project. So let's take a look. I have the website pulled up here. Let's go ahead and snap this in. So this is their website. Once you're logged in, you can take a look at all the different things if you have an active subscription. So there's HDRIs, like I said. They have a bunch of different lights in here as well. And then we've got all sorts of different materials. We've got some models that are broken down into some different categories. We got some abstract things. We got some stuff for like broadcast, some stylized stuff, which some of that you saw here. They got some cool things like these little factory models, these little, I really like the Easter Island heads. They've also got a bunch of just textures in general, so all sorts of different things that you can use. They've got like light gobos and different things in there, which I should have thrown on the scene actually, but I didn't. Maybe I'll throw that in the final render. But they've also got this broken down from different collections, so you can look at it through the different collections if you're interested in all of that. But personally, I just like to go through the different categories. But this scene is just set up with that, just some of their materials. You can see they're really, really nice materials, and the models are broken down really well. I've just brought them into the models into a soft create node, and just brought in a file there. They are not USD, they're FBX, so you can convert them over if you'd like. Let's go ahead and set this to Houdini GL for a moment and take a look at the library. So the way that they allow you to import textures is really, really nice. They have their own little plugin, so you can install it. It's super easy to install. They have a thing on their website that walks you through it, a little video that walks you through it. And then all you have to do is come up and activate the Greyscalegorilla shelf. And then you click this little import material, and then you go, import material button. And you go to wherever all of the materials are saved. So I've downloaded a few of them. And then once you're in that folder, you just click accept. And you have a bunch of materials that pop up. So all the materials in that file or in that folder. And then you can select. I don't have the other renderers set up. Redshift, I don't think it's out for Houdini 20 yet. But we can select Karma, so we can select the new ones. I've brought in a few here, so concrete and some clay. So let's bring in some of these other ones. So maybe we'll bring in the acacia wood. Maybe we'll bring in this one's kind of cool, I think, and this one. So once we do that, we select which ones we want, or we can select them all. We can click this little import. It takes just a second, and then it says okay. And it brings it into the material context. So all you have to do from there, or at least to keep things organized, I'm gonna just line these up and I'll select them all and copy them over, and then come into our stage context, bring them into material library, and then we can just paste them in there. And they are all set up at that point. So if we take a look at the actual inside of the materials there, actually everything is promoted onto the top of this that you, well, the things that you're going to use the most. I suppose if you want to adjust like the normal intensity and stuff, you can do that in there. But like the texture scale, the offset, the rotation of the UVs, this one has a height setup, normal map. So they're all set up using Material X, which is super nice. And you can affect all their settings just on the base level of the material there. So you don't have to actually dive in, which is super, super nice. All of their materials are really, really nice. So let's go ahead and just fire up the Karma XPU. And we can change over in the material linker. Maybe let's go in here and select this. So maybe we want to change the little model textures here. So we'll go just delete these out of here. We'll accept that. And there's a little bug with Houdini 20. So if you've got the material folder selected in the material linker, and you, like, for example, if I select this one and I go to drag some stuff in here, watch this link includes right there. That's going to go from 2 to 3. You see it just goes to 3 right there, and this changes. So just keep that in mind. You may need to just actually select the actual material here. So maybe we'll change it to this little craft soap candy cane. Go in here, we'll just select the palace and the pyramid. You can just drag those in there and click accept. And let's unselect those. Let's just restart it. I don't think that has the material applied. I don't think that's what it looks like. So it'll take a second to load in. There we go. So you see we get a pretty cool material. Actually, that is a really, really sweet material. Let's go ahead. That was the craft soap. So if we want to change the scale of this, I'm just going to copy this parameter and paste the relative reference there. Part of me wishes they'd have that set up by default, but I'm not sure if they can with their little plugin. I'm sure they probably could if they wanted to, but let's just change the scale here. So maybe we'll lower this down, get some more detail in there. That looks super cool. I really, really like that material quite a bit. And then maybe let's change this background to that acacia wood there. So come back to our material linker. Let's come to the fine sandy right there. Let's just delete this rule out. And let's come to our acacia wood planks, drag that over, and then we can select our backdrop and just drag that in there. And then again, we can come back into our material and just come in here, copy the parameter, paste relative references. And obviously my background is a little bent here, but or my little backdrop. But you see the materials update super quick, and they are super, super nice. So really, really nice materials. I really like all the different materials that they have. And maybe we'll try the other one just to demonstrate this little recycled plastic material that they have. So again, we'll just come here, we'll get rid of that, come to recycled plastic, and then just drag our backdrop in there. Click accept. And then maybe we need to adjust the scale on that one as well. But overall, I really like all the different textures that they have in here. They've got really, really nice materials in this. So that one's not very nice for this scene. But let's go ahead and change that back to the clay fine. Oops, I've already got a rule set up in there. Let's drop that backdrop back in there. So that material didn't work super great for this scene, but it worked. These fine sand work a little bit better for this specific case, in my opinion. But overall, like I said, these materials are super, super nice. I really, really like the way that they look. Obviously, we can zoom in here on maybe one of these palaces and really take a look at the detail on these textures. So very, very, very nice in there. And then the dome lights, I don't think they have the Greyscale Gorilla like HDRI link working for Houdini. I don't know if that's something that they have. But the HDRI link, if you're familiar with Cinema 4D, basically it's like a little library with all the different HDRIs that has a little thumbnail of what they look like, and you can just select which one you want and then it'll load on in. But not too difficult to bring that into Houdini as well. Just load up the texture in your dome light and you're all set. But you can see this material has processed pretty well and it looks super, super nice. You can see some of these little reflections on the pyramid there. But yeah, so check out the Greyscale Gorilla website. You can download all the different textures and materials that they have. There's a ton of different things in here, so it's really, really simple to get going here. They've got an absolute ton of materials. I think in total, the library of HDRI's materials, models and all that has over 4,000 different things in it. So there's a ton of stuff. And to be honest with you, a lot of that is materials. There is a ton of different materials here. So I've got a little more kind of abstract ones. I've got, you know, realistic ones, road textures. I've got the clays that we looked at. I've got them all broken down super well as well. We've got concrete, some more organic stuff, so that some of that soap, this soap was that texture we applied. So different things in there. Bunch of stuff that you would need in normal, you know, everyday work that you're doing inside of your favorite software. So this is available for Blender now as well as Unreal Engine. So that's super cool. You can transfer, if you render over in Unreal Engine, you can take stuff over there and render it in there as well, or you can stay in Houdini and do it all in there. But like I said, their little importer that they have here works extremely well for materials. Really like the way that they have that set up. Just select which ones you want, and then it's as simple as dropping down. Like I said, I don't have Redshift installed right now because I don't think it's out for Houdini 20, but if I had that installed, it'd be in this little list right here. I just select that, and then I would be able to import which one I wanted. So let's even just set this to Mantra and import a couple just to see. So there, it's got this all set up. You can see now this is all set up with the principled shader for Mantra. So if you are still using that for whatever reason, you can bring in materials for that as well. I don't know what all renderers they support. I know obviously Karma, Mantra, Redshift, I think Octane as well. I'm not sure if they support any other ones, but overall this, it works really, really well, and their materials are super nice. So I'll leave a link to them in the description so you can take a look through all their stuff on there. But like I said, this isn't a, I'm not making any money off of this per se, but I was given access to this this library for a demonstration purpose here for you. So definitely take a look at it. It is super useful. I've been around the Greyscalegorilla stuff for a long time. They've got training on Redshift as well as part of the Greyscalegorilla Plus. So if you're new to Redshift, even if it's not inside Houdini, the training is done in Cinema 4D, I believe. So even if you're new to Redshift inside Houdini, that would be helpful to learn the different settings, because it's basically just settings for Redshift. They're mostly the same between all the different softwares, so just got to figure out where they are in your different software. But anyways, thank you guys for watching. Like I said, I'll leave a link in the description if you want to check out more of the Greyscalegorilla Plus library. But anyways, thank you guys for watching, and have a good day.